We are all fitted with our gear, ready to hop on board. We're doing 3 dives today and doing a bit of island hopping in between. Should be awesome.
The thing is, you don't see
I've got my dive lens set up on my GoPro, so it actually turns the footage a bit more red because as you go down deeper, the first colors to go are yellow and red, and it just kind of does a bit of color correction to reduce the blues and make the colors more vibrant underwater. Is that a big fish?
Yeah, big fish.
We are just about ready to go. Flippers are on fleek. Wetsuit on fleek. But it is so hot in here. I've got my weight belt on. Now I'm gonna get my respirator all set up once our guides are ready.
Wow.
Don't even have to go scuba diving because it's so clear. You can see everything down there. First dive was a huge success. We saw turtles, squid, we saw a spearfish, which is that massive flat looking fish that kind of is narrow but really tall. We saw orangutan crab, we saw a rock frog, or no, it's called a fish frog? No, something frog, and it's actually like, basically, it's a frog, so it walks on 4 feet at the bottom of the water, but it actually looks like coral, and it's really, really cool. Yeah, it was just a really good dive. The water is really clear. The current was a bit strong, but other than that, it was really good. $90 to $100 for 3 dives. Well, Canadian, so maybe like 80 US dollars, a bit less than 80 US dollars for 3 dives, which is really good. It includes like coffee, food, island hopping, and great company.
Me?
Yeah, you. Well, you don't come with a package. It's cool though. How these things work is you basically, it's like a vest. You strap it around you, and you've got this piece right here, and you press this to inflate, this to deflate, and when you're actually coming back up to the surface, you'd think you'd inflate your vest, but it's actually the opposite. When you're swimming to the top, you want to deflate your vest because as you come up, the air starts expanding, and so if you start inflating your vest, you could actually rupture the vest, I guess, or even worse would be if you come up to the surface, it'll actually start making you rise faster and faster and faster because the air expands. And that'll lead to you going to the surface too quickly. And if you shoot out, it can lead to like your blood bubbling, nitrogen poisoning basically. And I mean, although it's not really a risk at the depths we're diving, it's a good habit to get into in case you do your advanced diving. So we are doing a bit of snorkeling in between dives, and we're actually going into that cave where we've been informed someone died last, I don't know, when?
How long ago?
Maybe it was a long time ago. But someone basically got lost in the cave while scuba diving. Didn't find their way out, and we're also told that there's poisonous sea snakes that if you get bitten, you have to go to Manila, which is an hour away by flight, because that's the only place to get the antidote, and they're very poisonous, so we will avoid those And it's a breeding ground for the sea snakes in there, so. It's become pretty overcast since we've first started diving. You can actually hear thunder in the distance, so hopefully it doesn't come this way. But this may be my last vlog entry after an encounter with a sea snake, so nice knowing everyone.
My goggles! They came off! Thank you. My savior. Into the cave we go! Statue of Mary.
Number two, it was a really good dive again. We saw a massive school of fish being attacked by a larger school of fish, and just the way they swim together is really cool. And this is small lagoon, and we're gonna have our little lunch. The diving didn't go quite as expected today. After the second dive, I came up and I started noticing my ear really hurt from the pressure. And then we had lunch and it actually got way, way worse, to the point that I had to go after the second dive, and like I took someone else's boat to get back so I could get some ibuprofen. And then basically I've just been in bed since then. The ear is still pretty bad. It's my right ear. And the pressure is like really, really built up, but it's not nearly as painful as it was earlier. I'm not sure whether it's because the pressure is being let out or because I've taken a fair amount of drugs to try to ease the pain. But anyways, I'll be okay. It is definitely a tiny bit better, but not exactly how I wanted the day to go. But the first two dives were amazing. Laura luckily completed the third dive, so she went on without me. And she saw a sea cucumber. That was the extent of her third dive. Oh,
and
she also she saw a stingray, which would have been cool. And a box fish. So she saw a bit. In the Philippines, their big sport is boxing and basketball. And so pretty much everywhere you go, there's tons of basketball courts. Ball is life.